What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Diablo 3 Necromancer beta. Today we're looking at Challenge Rift. From what I can tell, it gives you a, like, if you look at the soul mirror, it gives you somebody's build. I'm not really sure how this works. But like, this should not be here. This should be something else completely, and this also shouldn't be here. So if this is somebody's build, they were like halfway done with finishing it before they got switched. I don't really understand it completely, but anyways, we have basically a grenades build here. It's really weird. Not everything's finished. We do have our 6 point bonus here, so that's pretty good. We have discipline. I mean, we have it's the basis of a grenades build. So all I know is we do a challenge or a rift. I'm not really sure. Target time is 6:41. So this is very similar to to what I played last season. So like, I'm not worried about timing. I should be able to finish it no problem. The problem is, Vengeance is not going to have 100% uptime because of the missing items for the build, but again, that's not a big deal. Hopefully we can finish it. This is obviously going to help a lot. Yeah, so like I said, as far as I can tell, it gives you a random build and you have to complete the rift in under the time it says, which this is like 6:30 something. So maybe you're doing the person's personal best rift difficulty 35. You know, I'm not exactly sure. Again, I'm not exactly sure how this is working out, so. So we have to finish this in like 6.5 minutes or something. And this is, you know, might be my current favorite Demon Hunter build, so I'm not really too worried about that. I haven't gotten to try the new Impale build yet, so I'm a little disappointed that this isn't that, but you know, I know this build, I know it does a ton of damage. If this is somebody's build, they almost have all of the gear, so. Yeah, I was in the 80s for Greater Rifts, I think, last season. I didn't do much recording last season, but I got pretty high. I was on the leaderboard for a little while. That's it, 6:54 is our time. I was on the leaderboard for a little while. But I just didn't stick with it. Kind of got, you know, burnt out a little bit, so. Yeah, like this build currently, even missing the things that it's missing, could probably still do Torment 13. Like, he's got almost all of it. Again, that's if this is how it works, if you just get given somebody's build randomly. I don't really know. Yeah, but this is a great build. I mean, I Yeah, it needs Nemesis Bracer. It's missing Nemesis Bracer. I guess it doesn't need Nemesis Bracers, but... I mean, that's the... That's it. Time to beat 654. I guess I get a cash. Well, thanks. I guess you don't get it, just because it's, you know... But yeah, you can't change this or anything. Last known profile. Yeah. So yeah, I guess it looks like it just picks a random profile. Maybe. And last known profile. And it gives you what they had set up. So at one point they were doing a companion build, and it looks like they were switching to grenades or vice versa. And they didn't finish. Maybe they got kicked offline. I don't know. But yeah, that's that, I guess. Doesn't have all of his emeralds either. So, yeah, I'm not 100% sure about that. But definitely interesting. Okay. Yeah, so I did the challenge run. Now, I'm assuming that this is different every day. You get a different every day. Now, I'm curious if this goes to my mailbox. So, we're going to switch back to adventure mode. We're on our necromancer. We're going to start the game. And we're going to have a bunch of stuff in our mailbox, because our current seasonal character, our witch doctor, is... Yeah, okay. So our witch doctor is, you know, seasonal, so I get mailed all that stuff. So, collection of relics gathered throughout the ages. Oh, that is fantastic. Look at that, look at... I'm overburdened. If that's what it gives you every time, that's absolutely wonderful. Yeah, that's actually, that's pretty cool if that's what it does. Once a day you get to try the challenge rift and get some free loot. Pretty cool. Well, I want this rift to go a little quicker, so we're just gonna drop the difficulty down to Torment 1. This way I don't waste up too much more time. Okay, we got a goblin nearby. It's a blood thief, so it's like really not that cool. I didn't switch up my skills at all. You know, I don't. I think they're still hammering stuff out right now. Because, like, literally everything. All the primary skills basically do the same amount of damage, other than Siphon Blood, actually. And I preferred Siphon Blood. This will be a challenge. Oh, that's really cool. The golem comes right back after you make the pile of corpses. So I can definitely see how that would be very useful. What did we get at 17? Bloodsucker rune. Oops. Teeth. Launches 5 razor sharp teeth that deal 300% weapon damage. That actually, let's take a look at this. This sounds pretty cool. That's pretty cool. More AE, you know, and then Siphon Blood, Bloodsucker. That's pretty cool as well. And Leech, curse the target area. Cursed enemies have a chance to heal the attacker when they are struck for 1% of their total health. Last 30 seconds. We'll grab that, and we're going to switch this back to Death Nova. Now, we're going to have to try one of these. Yeah, I liked that. That was pretty good. Leech was pretty cool looking. Now, I don't know if it affects enemies that walk into the area. It's going to be kind of hard to tell. Does not seem like it affects enemies that walk into the area. Just being in the area when it spawns. Which is fine. Let a skeleton die. I really like that the pets just auto-summon. You don't have to worry about finding corpses or anything like that. Of course, this could be changed. You know, we are in the beta still, so... I like that ability because one of the things the witch doctor is missing is you can't tell your pets what to attack. You know, you're always like wishing that they would attack something else and they never do. So that's really cool, and the ability to send the golem in just to blow up into corpses, which would then allow you to do damage to what you want to do with corpse explosion or the corpse missile ability, whatever that was called. That's really cool. It's definitely helps. I mean, you can just leave your guys to attack. But you can have them, go from thing to thing. Now, it costs essence, I believe, to do that. Yeah, it only costs 25 essence, so that's not bad. Also let you regroup your pets, so if your pets get all spread out like they do unbelievably with a witch doctor, they just spread out and you have no, like I said, you have no control over a witch doctor's pets. Just adding that much control to the necromancer, I mean, it's not even that much. You're just like, go attack that, and that's so good. Like, it's so good. And that's good because sometimes when you get the Rift Guardian in a normal rift and you just want to get him killed and there's just enemies all around. Or when your pets are being stupid and won't go in and attack stuff. Really digging it. Hoping that function stays, because that is fantastic. You just send him right to attack the boss. That's it. Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to see what kind of legendaries and things we get for the Necromancer. What kind of builds we can make when the time comes. Because right now it's fantastic. And I do love the abilities that we have. Okay, we just got bone armor. Oh, that makes you look cool as hell. Yeah, that makes you look wicked sweet with that bone armor. What are you whining about, Diag? Dag's always freaking out, you know? He's a good boy, though. Alright, so, anyways, bone armor looks pretty cool. I believe I read that it can stack up to 10 times. Yeah, okay, but every time you use it, it's like the Witch Doctor's Soul Harvest or whatever. Every time you do it, regardless of how many stacks you have, it resets the stacks. So you gotta be careful in that aspect.
Do not fear the end.
Yeah, Death Nova is pretty cool. It looks pretty cool. I'm excited just to see other things as well. Got a legendary. What do we get? Homing pads. I'm fine with that, you know. Level 20, we get more passives and unlock our second passive slot. So with that, let's see what we got. We now have Commander of the Dead. The essence cost of Command Skeleton and the cooldown of Command Golem are reduced by 30%. That's good. And Swift Harvesting increases the attack speed of Bone Spike, Siphon Blood, and Grimscythe by 15%. Okay, and now what do we have here? Grimscythe has dual scythes. Slash with two summon scythes in front of you. Okay, so it's much shorter. Which, if I just read, probably says. No, it doesn't. Okay. 150 damage is physical and push enemies together. That's pretty cool. We're going to stick with this. Death Nova. Skeletal Mage now has Skeletal Archer. Raise a Skeleton Archer. It deals 400% weapon damage. Skeleton archers increase your attack speed by 3% for 5 seconds each time they deal damage, max 10 stacks. So, did these guys also? Yes, they also last 6 seconds. And Death Nova has Unstable Compound. Each cast increases the radius of your next Nova by 5 yards up to 2 times. We'll use that. And now we have Frenzy. Commanded skeletons go into a frenzy, gaining 25% increased attack speed for the duration. We're definitely going to pick that up. I didn't mean to do that. Decay, we're just going to use that, see what he looks like, of course. Going to hit that up, see what they look like. Going to keep Leech, and I think this is just bone armor, yeah. That's super good. Okay, so Decay Golem doesn't really look much different, and neither do the skeletons. Guess the skeletons just don't want to come over yet. Oh, that was pretty cool. He just leaped across everything to get there. wonder if we have poison Nova in the Novas. I'll have to look. Because poison Nova was a necromancer ability in Diablo 2. Let's head back to town. Okay, let's see. I wish I looked at that sooner. Oh, look! A Necromancer Blue! That's fantastic! Let's take a look at it. That's pretty cool looking. It's a scythe. Obviously we're gonna equip this, it's much better. Okay, so we want to look and see if there is a normal Poison Nova. Doesn't look like there is. Maybe Blight is. That's alright though. Bone Nova sounds exciting. There's no bone wall either, which is fine. Alright guys, that's going to do it for us for today. Gotta speak to Orak to close the rift, but...
I understand so much more.
We got the Dizzying Curse. But yeah, that's Necromancer. I mean, he looks pretty cool. He looks like he'll be a lot of fun. The Golem looks fantastic. I hope that they make the different runes look a little different like they have for other pets. Even if it's just more of a color change, because he looks pretty similar. The skeletons have like a little bit of a color change. I think the scarves were a different color and the pants. But they're pretty cool. And I'm hoping one of the sets allows for like skeleton mages to last forever or something. You know, that would also be kind of cool. But yeah, that's what we got. Obviously, there's still other stuff like Blood Rush, Bone Spirit. You know, there's all the different abilities we still haven't looked at. But that's probably as much as I'm going to play. I might only play a little bit more in Necromancer. It's nice that I got to try it out. But I am by no means in any rush to flood myself of Necromancer before it actually comes out. But first impressions is it's a lot of fun. And I feel like they are still working out specifics. But definitely a lot of fun. Definitely really cool. Love command skeletons. Absolutely love that idea where you just get to tell your skeletons what to attack. Otherwise they'll just attack whatever. I think that's fantastic. I wish the Golem had something similar. Command the Golem to the target location where it freezes enemies for 3 seconds. That's not bad. The Golem becomes a tornado of bone, carrying all nearby enemies to the target location and rooting them in place. That's also really good. We might be using Bone Golem eventually. Flesh-consuming Golem. The Golem consumes corpses at the targeted location, increasing its damage by 30% per corpse. That's also really cool. And Blood Golem. The Golem sacrifices itself, healing you for 25% of your health and reconstructs at the targeted location. As the Golem reconstructs, veiny tendrils damage nearby enemies for 450% weapon damage. Also sounds really cool. So all the Golems are pretty cool, and I can definitely see a use for all of them. As far as Command Skeleton go, skeletal minions will heal you for your total health while being commanded. The target of your command is frozen. That's pretty cool. And now commands your skeletons to explode, dealing 80% weapon damage to enemies within 15 yards. That's also really cool. I don't know. I really like the abilities on Command Skeleton and Command Golem. So hopefully they keep going. Corpse Lance. I really did like Corpse Lance. It was pretty cool. Corpse Explosion, obviously, is definitely more fun. But yeah, like I said, most stuff just seems to be, you know, the same amount of damage. Like Death Nova isn't a lot of damage. Teeth isn't a ton of damage. But of course, once you have actual sets and things like that, it'll be a lot better. health restored but no longer restores essence. That's a little iffy. Essence gain increased to 20% or to 20 while you are at full health. Damage is increased by 10% each time damage is dealt, max 10 stat. That's really cool. And enemies are slowed by 75%. Yeah, so there's a lot of cool stuff going on with the Necromancer. So hope you guys enjoyed. I know I'm really gonna like the Necromancer when he's released. I definitely like what I've played of him here. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.